Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Ecology here, and welcome to the World of Warships test server. And in this test server, you'll be seeing me do test servery things with this ship. And as you can see, my name isn't Ecology, it's the Ship King, because I had to make a new account. But as you can see at the bottom, they basically start you off with tier 7s, and you have tier 1s in the game to start off with, except for premium vehicles, which is upsetting. Another thing about the premium or the test server is it doesn't have a training room, but you do get the introduction mission, which I hope comes next patch, because it is really helpful for new players to have that. So yeah, other than that, there's nothing really interesting in the tech tree. No new ships, no anything, which is somewhat upsetting. But that's not really what the test server is. The test server is to test new stuff, and hopefully I get to show you some stuff. There are two new maps, which hopefully I get to show you, and I think four maps got weather effects, and I'll show you weather effects when I get to play on those. So sit back and relax and see if you like what's coming next in World of Warships. So here we are, everyone, with one of the new maps. This is Trident, I think. And as you can see, the teams are mostly tier 7s, because why do you want to play anything higher than that to be a seal clubber? But it looks like a night map. Or a sunsetting map, I guess. You got some nice clouds over there. Nice sky. Got the sun setting over that way with the clouds. I like games that you can actually see the clouds move. This is actually a pretty beautiful map. As you can see, there's islands in the center like any traditional map. It looks like a trident because you got the staff, and then you got the three prongs of a trident. And then you got some islands back here for the aircraft carrier to hide behind. Same thing around here for the aircraft carrier.
Action stations.
So, let's get into this combat battle situation here. I am playing the Miyoko. It's a Japanese. The clouds look amazing. Like, I really like the way the sun sets. I can't tell if it's sunsetting or sun rising on this map. It should be, I think it's sunset, but it might be sunrise. I can't really tell. Listen to those airplanes. They sound awesome. Just so far looking at the map, it looks so good. I really enjoy looking at this map of World of Warships. I really do. The islands look fantastic. Ships look fantastic. Airplanes look fantastic. I'm going to switch to armored piercing here. Another thing that I like, and I hope is in this patch, and it will come to the real client, is... Well, let me reload my shells here so I can show you what I mean. Is that you can actually see your shell. Like, look at that. That you can see your shell spinning. You can see that it's like that. And I like that. I like that that's a thing. And I hope it comes into the next patch, because I like that. Instead of having, like, a glowing orb that's in the sky, you can actually see that it's a shell. You can actually see that it's a thing. And that's one thing that I like, is actually seeing that it's an actual shell flying through the air, not just a blob of light. Like in World of Tanks. World of Tanks is just a blob of light coming towards your tank. And let's say I'm shooting at that guy, and I shoot, let's say, here. There's a chance that ball of light might glitch through the ground and go through thing. But when they actually modeled in a sort of shell, then hitting the ground is always going to be a negative. Why are you guys hugging each other? That's fine with me. I'll just hit you with high explosive next time when I reload. But it does look like a very beautiful map. I don't know why it showed that it is a night map. Unless it'll be the first map that actually transitions from day to night as the time goes on. That would be awesome. That would be awesome. I'm liking the new sounds as well. Like, there's a lot of new sounds when your ship gets hit with shells. Like, it doesn't sound like just a normal hit. Like, it sounds different depending how it hits your ship. Nah, I kind of like that. I like difference. Fire the shells, I must shoot. I always forget that Japanese cruisers have torpedoes before. It's always too late. Like, god dang it, I could have fired a load of torpedoes. The thing about World of Warships, it's always follow the leader. Like, if there's a big group going this way, you usually tend to go this way. You don't really want to go off the beaten path, but a lot of people don't like that. I don't mind it. So that's basically the new map, Trident. I would show you in a training room, but there's no training rooms on World of Warships, which is kind of upsetting that there's no training rooms. I wish there was, so I can show you the map in more detail and show you all the little bits that this map has to offer. But sadly, I can't do that. So this is what the map looks like from the top-down view. Got islands. It's pretty nice to me. I like the atmosphere. I like that it's like a sunset. We're fighting at the sunset, and I kind of like that. I need to start traversing. Ow. That's my citadel. Oh no, people are sinking left and right. I think it's the destroyer. But it would really, really curiosity if... Do ships sink differently? That looks like a complete capsize. Oh my gosh, do ships... Look at that sinking! Oh my gosh, that is awesome! Did they add new sinking physics to the game? Ow, this ship has no armor. I'm too focused on other things to care. Like, is there new ship physics? Is there, or ship sinking physics, or more realism? Oh, that'd be so awesome. I don't care if I die. Please kill me. Nagato, murder me now. I want to see my ship sink. I'm like excited to see my ship sink, which is something you never want to hear. I'm gonna die. Don't want to, but I'm going to. There we go. Alright, my ship is now sinking. Does it sink spectacularly? Is it capsizing? What is it doing? Oh, it just seems like it's just gonna sink. Nah? Oh? It's rolling over. I'm so excited. Oh, there it goes. I capsized. Oh my gosh, I capsized. Oh my god. I see the bottom of the ship. Look, my propellers are still spinning. Oh my gosh, that is terrifyingly awesome. That is awesome. I need to take screenshots of this because this is awesome. Oh my gosh, it capsized. Something everyone's been like begging them to do is add better sinking, and I capsized. Oh my gosh. Am I going to do like the Titanic where my bow's going to stick up in the air? Oh, I hope so. This is freaking fantastic. I love the bubbles. I love the bubbles. Oh my. Yep, there goes my bow. Oh, I love it. Oh, I love it. That's so cool. I don't care if I sink now. Like, the sinking actually looks fantastic. What's another ship that's low health? It's a Ranger. I want to see another ship sink. I'm so excited to see ship sinks now. Come on, Nagato or Pensacola. Finish them off. Dive bombers incoming. Ooh. Ooh. That anti-aircraft gun sounded awesome. I don't know about you, but did you hear the oh my, that guy's sinking fast. But I heard different variation of guns. Like, I heard the Bofors and the Orlikans separately. Before, it was just a standard sound to me. You can actually see the water inside. Oh, that is awesome. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, this is awesome. I like this. I give sinking a thumbs up. Now it's sinking slowly because all the air is trapped in these compartments. Especially in the conning tower, all the air is trapped. So it's sinking a tad bit slow. Oh, this is awesome. Oh, it's sinking. It's going down. Oh, I'm so amused right now. I'm so amused. See, it doesn't really want to capsize because most of the weight is over on this side of the ship. So it's slowly sinking below the waves. There it goes. Bow first, stern last. Goodbye. Oh, I love it. Look at all that splashing. It looks like a real ship going down. Now the only thing left they need to add is like chairs and tables and life rafts floating in the water. That would be awesome. Who else is about to die? You're stuck on an island, but you're about to die. You still have life left in you. What about the destroyer? You still have some health. I'm going to go follow this Miyoko, because he looks like he's going to die anytime soon. But I like the new death physics. Yeah, does it look darker? Does it look like the sun set any much more? I don't know. It's still like 20 minutes. Like, sun don't set in like 20 minutes. It takes hour-long process, I guess. But this map is awesome. I didn't realize that there was new ship sinking physics. That's awesome. Good job, Wargaming, on that. Good job, World of Warships developers. Good job. Round of applause. I give it a thumbs up. Really want to hear anti-aircraft guns going off, though. But, here comes a dive bomber squadron. Let's see if we can hear anti-aircraft guns. There goes the Orlikans. Orlikans. What does he have? Is all his main anti-aircraft guns are broken? Oh no, he has the pianos. Ah. The 5-inchers and the pianos. He doesn't have any Orlikans. Or Bofors, my bad. Stop shooting at him for like 2 seconds. I want to hear... Ooh, torpedoes. Ouch. Oof. Oof. He got raped by torpedoes. Down he goes. Stern first. Okay, that makes sense because he got hit in the stern. Is he going to flip, though? Oh, I like the new... Aww, I don't get to finish watching it. I'm sorry. Oh, I can't wait for that. Like, the thing that I complained is there was, like, no enjoyment to watch your ship sink because... It was all like, you tilt halfway and then you sink anyways. It's no flip over. But I saw the very first capsize in World of Warships. I don't care that we lost. That was fantastic. And let's see if I can find the other brand new map. Or the maps that have the weather effects. So, I'll see you when I find one of those. Here we are on North. And in the Miyoko, this is the map that has weather. It's either snow or rain. And as you can see by the screen, it's definitely rain. So here we go. Where's the rain? Whoa, it's sunny. What? I bet the rain's coming from that direction. So it's going to come in, but I want rain. But it's sunny. I don't get that. But if you look up there, you can see it is moving. Those clouds are moving. So that storm is coming in, and it will cross the map and then disappear. And I like that. I like that a lot. So, yeah, this is the Miyoki. No camouflage or anything. It's not a bad ship, it just has absolutely no armor whatsoever. And that's the only problem that I don't like about the Japanese cruisers, is their very, very much lack of armor. And I'm not a fan of that. So let's see if I can get some rain to fall on my ship. Some weather effects. See, when I first saw that there was weather effects on this map, I was like, where's the rain? I see a sunny day. At first, I'm like, wait, this map's sunny? Interesting. But, yeah, there will be pouring downpour rain on this map. And I can't wait. With the new destruction physics, which lets your ship actually roll over onto its belly, oh my gosh, that is awesome. I was blown away. Like... Hush, hush, hush. I'm all So I'm pumped up. I should live stream World of Warships on the test server probably tomorrow, but I have stuff to do tomorrow. But oh my gosh. I want to live stream it. I really do now, because it's just so awesome. Alright, here's the first target, the Pensacola. Come on, guns. Oh, he's turning away. No, he's turning away. I want armor piercing, though. He has a cruiser. Cruisers, you fire armored piercing, unless it's like a 3-tier higher cruiser, and then you just like, no. But that's a Pensacola. It doesn't have armor, just like me, but he has more armor than me, so it's, yeah. God dang it. Wrong button. Whoopsie. Wrong button. Well, that was my mistake. That was my mistake. I want to hit something. I really do. There's planes over there. I want to hear my anti-aircraft guns. Because that's another problem that I complain about World of Warships, is the anti-aircraft guns sound the same. Like, the Bofors sound the same as, like, a 76 or something like that. And it just, like, it doesn't please me. Like, I want different sounds for each cannon. Like, I want the machine guns to sound like machine guns. I want the 50 cal to sound like a 50 cal. Like, an Orlikan is not a 50 cal. It's a 20 mil. Anti-aircraft gun crews are on normal alert. Yeah, yeah. Sorry I made you guys worry. Oh, that's not... will it hit? Yes, it did, and I impacted him, so he's now lost a gun. I need to turn around. I need to turn... I need to make a turn. Turn, trip, turn. Ouch. Yes, yes, yes. I damaged his engines. Come on. Reload. Thank you. He's now slowing down, so it should be much easier to hit him in the good parts. I citadeled him. Turn, 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 turn. Awesome. Oh, come on, shells. Don't. Come on. Yes, there we go. There we go. Be nice. Ow. 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 You know what I'm not doing? I'm not dumping my torpedoes at him, which is something I should be doing. Because this ship has yummy, delicious torpedoes that need to be hitting the target. Come on. Come on, shells. Finish them off. Yes! Ha 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 ha. I got a kill. Enemy cruiser destroyed. Now, it'll be interesting of what the ship does when it's on an island. Because theoretically, if you're stuck on an island, you shouldn't be able to sink. You should just be stuck on an island. Well, you're a nice-looking rock face. Oh, my engine's knocked out. I did not know that. I've, like, heard the clunk, clunk, clunk sound. I'm like, why is my clunk clunking? Like, oh, yeah, I'm my engines. But I have the commander skill, which gives me the ability to keep running with a broken engine or something like that. So where's the weather effect, you might be saying? Like, yeah. I'm saying the same thing as well. Where's the rain? Where is the rain? Is that it down there? Looks like the rain squall's coming in. Looks like it. I think it's always randomized. Like, it might come in slow or it might come in instantaneously. Which makes sense because rain is unpredictable. You never know when it's going to rain. So, yeah. So after I show you the rain effect on this map, the only last thing I want to show you is the snow and the other brand new map, which I'm not sure what tier it is, so I might have to try to get a tier 10 to show you it, which will be upsetting, but if that's what the case is, I gotta do it. Look at the village. Isn't it pretty? Where is the rain? I want the rain. Where is the rain? Da-dum, da-dum, da-dum. This is one of the map where it got the weather effects. Maybe it's over there. I'm not sure. I'm confused. Maybe it's random. Maybe this the time I spawned on it, there's no rainstorm. Maybe it's anti-rain. That's upsetting. That poor anti-aircraft gun is just all smashed and broken. I am somewhat disappointed that there's no rain. Somewhat disappointed. Approaches visible 8 kilometers. Beth? So that's basically a warning that says the cyclone is 8 kilometers away. Approaches. Interesting. So I think the rain is coming. I think it's coming. It's 8 kilometers away, I guess. I think that's it. I think that's the cyclone. I think that's it. I think it will be coming in soon. I'm excited. Oh, what's that? Is that rain? Oh, I see rain. I think. Is it? Oh, there it is. I see it. It's raining. Is my ship getting wet yet? Oh, it is raining. I hear thunder. Oh, this is awesome. It's like not fully there yet, but it's forming and I like it. But my ship's getting wet. As you can see, if you can see very closely, there is rain droplets on my ship. Right there, you can see there. There's a couple there. But it's not really raining hard enough to be more visible yet. But you can see on the turret as well. Like, oh, this is awesome. Rain is awesome. Hard to see, but awesome. But this isn't even the heart of the storm yet. Like, it's going to get more stormy. And going to look much more pretty. I also think it has effect on view range as well. Because it's much harder to see in rain, and it should be like that. There we go, we're in the storm. There's the clouds. Look at that. Look at the storm. You can really see my ship getting wet now. Look at the rain. Look at the rain effect on the ship now. Look at that. That is awesome. My ship is wet. There's puddles forming on the ship. This is awesome. Good job. Look, you can even see it on the turret. On the top of the turret, you can see rain droplets. That's awesome. This is awesome. Wargaming did a good job with this. I have to give them an A+. Could be a little bit more tweaks in the future, yes. But for right now, it is the best. I wonder if they took this from the developers of World of Tanks Xbox or PlayStation, because they already have rain. They already have this in the game. For the Xbox version of World of Tanks. So I wonder if they just took it from Xbox and implemented it in. Because look at that. You can see that my ship is wet. It is visibly wet. And I like that. I like it. You can see that the sun is now covered by the clouds. It's much darker. It's much more atmospheric. And it's just awesome. I'm chasing down these ships down here, but my ship's not going as fast. Just look at the clouds. It's pouring rain. A ship is visibly wet everywhere. You can see rain droplets. Just so awesome. Now I'm not make. See, look, it's much more harder to see the ship, and I like that. Oh, that was a bad shot. Look at the two. Two's right there, so anywhere there is good. Now the next step is waves. Like, I think wave action needs to be increased just a little bit. Just a little bit. Oh, he's not paying attention at all. I'm going to launch a torpedo spread. Right after this. Here we go. Oh, no. Come on. I need to traverse the ship. I forgot. My torpedoes are in my butt. They're in the butt. Okay, awesome. Torpedoes are away. No, two. Give me two. I want two. Thank you. Fire him again. Who's shooting at me? Oh, it's probably the Pensacola. But come on, torpedoes. Finish them. Get rid of them. Come on. Oh. Someone killed him before I did. That's upsetting. Whew. But it's raining. You can hear thunder crackling in the background. You can see the rain droplets. Now it's really intense. Like, you can see that it's really, really intense now. And I like it. The only thing, like I said, waves. Big, bouncy waves. And I want to see wind. Like, take my exhaust and blow it, like, away. That'd be awesome. That'd be fantastically awesome. Also, lightning. Lightning would be fantastic. Like, see a bolt of lightning streak across the sky or hit the ground right in front of you. That would be great. Like, just random RNG lightning bolts. That would be great. Like, look at this ship. Look at the water effects on the ship. That's not what I wanted, though. But look at it. You can see that it's puddling up. It's a puddle. You can see that there's water on the turret. It looks fantastic. I hate to be standing out in the rain, but since they're ghosty goos, I guess they don't care. Yes, my ship is 90% controlled by ghosts. But look at it. It is fantastic. I like this. I like it a lot. I give the rain effect a thumbs up. I think it's fantastic, and it's not really, really tanking my system that much. I'm getting 50 to 60 to 30 frames per second. And I like that. That's pretty decent, in my opinion. Pretty decent. Granted, the rain effect on the random water should be looked at more, but I think it looks fantastic. Tell me in the comments what you think about the rain. Do you like the rain? Do you don't like the rain? Does it really hurt your system? Or can you not see the rain because your graphics are too low or something? I don't know. Mine is at maximum highest graphical setting ever, so I'm enjoying all this. Looks so awesome. Oh, it looks like the sun's going to come out soon. Looks like the squall's going to go away. Oh, this is awesome. It's so atmospheric. Like, I feel like I'm in a rain squall. I feel like my ship is getting drenched with rain. Granted, I wish there was wave action, but beggars can't be choosers, I guess. But look at that. Look at that. That's awesome. Awesome! And it was a victory, so awesome. That's also good. So, with that being said, I'm going to show you either the other map or the snow next. So, stay with me for more. So, this is the Colorado, and this is the hotspot map, one of the maps. Four maps that have rain on it. So when you start the match, it has rain. And my Colorado looks wet. Very wet. I wonder if you can hear raindrops on your ship. So I'm going to be quiet and see if we can hear raindrops. Interesting. So I'm not going to show you the whole battle. I just wanted to show you that this is one of the four maps that has weather effect. And I kind of like it because it gives something nice to a map that I'm not a big fan of. So, yeah. With that being said, I'll be back whenever I find snow or the brand new map. And we're back in port. And as you can see, I'm not in the other port. I'm in the New York port because, as you see, I saw that it's not full of snow and not a New Year's theme anymore. So I clicked on it and it's now super sunny and pretty nice, actually. I like it better sunny than snowy, and you can also hear a lot of interesting sounds, like this. You can hear sirens and a car horn, I guess. But I like it because you can see things. Like, there's the Empire State Building, there's the downtown area, there's the Statue of Liberty, there's the airship that flies around, and there's the ships. Must be inconvenient because there's a big-ass battleship. This is the North Carolina. I did research it, because I just wanted to test it out because my friend had this thing and he was complaining about it. I kind of like this thing. I like that it has decent armor. I like that it has good hit points. I like that it guns fires pretty fast. The only thing I don't like about this thing is the turret traverse is a tad bit slow, but that's fine. It's alright. You're probably but wondering, like, where are the, look at the blimp. Where are the winter map, or the snowing map, and the other new map that they're adding in? Well, I played for 2 hours straight, and I haven't found any. I haven't found it yet, which is kind of sad. But it is, it's basically the same map where, you saw the rain. The first time when I actually showed the whole battle where the rain squall came in and all that stuff. It's basically the same map, but snowing. Another thing I didn't show you, which I probably should, is the mountain range map. Basically, it's a map modeled after the South China Sea, so maybe I have to play a Chinese ship to play it. I don't know. I don't have a Chinese ship available on this account, which is upsetting, but, yeah. But, yeah, it's historical, used by, like, the Chinese. It's exotic cliffs and stuff like that. I really wish I could see it, but I don't know what tier it sees, so I could be playing in the wrong tier. It could be a tier 3, 4, 5 map, all I know. We sell Trident. Trident was the new map, and I was correct in a way. It has a feature of a day-night variant. Basically, it's the same map, but you can either get it in dawn, morning, evening, and night. So basically, that map can be a nighttime map. It just depends on what RNG is. And I like that. I like maps that are variants. Like, it might be this map, and it might be sunny, and then the next battle, you might be getting the same map, but it's nighttime. To me, I'd rather have that than having the same map, same conditions, over and over again, because that's boring. But if I get the same map, but different weather, different time periods, to me, that feels like it's interesting, because I might have fought on this map early in the morning, but late at night, I had to go back to this map to defend it again because the enemy came in to try to recapture the islands and blah 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 blah. And I feel like that's, to me, interesting because it's new in a way. Other than that, you saw the destruction feature. Some of the ships got changes with sounds and anti-aircraft guns, torpedoes, stuff like that. I won't go into big detail with it, but I really like this patch. It's the first time I'm on the test server. I really hope you enjoyed this video. I had so much fun on the test server. The big features I'm really looking forward to when this patch goes live is the new destruction of the ships, where the ship capsizes and flips over and sinks like the Titanic, basically. And I like that. I like that to death. I think that's the best feature coming in next patch. And the second feature that I really, really like next patch is the weather effect. I like that some maps are snowing. I like that some maps are rainy. I like that some maps are now time zoned, changeable, where you can be fighting in the morning and then fight at the evening on the same map. I think that's awesome. I hope they introduce more. What I hope will come in the future, waves. At least more vigorous waves, so when it starts downpouring, the wave's action looks more turned up. Like, it's not like a smooth, calm port like New York City is right now. But that's my opinion. Tell me in the comments what you think about the new changes coming to World of Warships. I find it interesting. I also really like the shell. When you press the Z key on your key, where you can follow your shell, I really like that the tracer is your shell, not just a dot of light. I really, really, really like that feature. So that's 3 good features I like that's coming in next patch, and hopefully they are all coming in next patch. If one of those aren't in next patch, I will be depressed. So that's basically the 3 key features that I like about this patch is the shells, the weather, and the being able to capsize. That I think that's fantastic. So like I said, in the comments section, tell me what you think about this patch. Do you like it? Do you hate it? Do you agree with me that some of these features are pretty cool? Or do you not agree because you have crappy computers and you can't really handle these new graphical features? Even though they are doing optimization. There's a new client optimization for this patch where you will download quicker and it's 2 to 3 times faster, basically. 50% lower configuration, blah, blah, blah. So it's supposed to make your computer run better when you play World of Warships, and I like that as well. Caring for the little guys, yep. So with that being said, thank you so much for watching. Again, I'm sorry that I didn't get to see the snow effect or that other new map, but it doesn't tell you on the World of Warships website what tier Mountain Ridge plays at, so I can't really, you know, I could try every single tier and see if it works, but that would take a couple more hours, and I kind of want to get this video. That little thing almost collided with that. I rewind the video and watch this little sailboat almost collide with a ferry. Do it. I dare you, because it did. I think that's hilarious. But yeah, I like it. So with that being said, thank you so much for watching. Clicky-click the like button if you like this video, and I'll see you in more videos. I probably will be doing a World of Warships live stream in 2 to maybe 3 days, depending on my schedule. Tomorrow I'm not going to be able to make videos. That's why I decided to take another day off yesterday, so I have a video today, so I don't miss 4 days, which would be upsetting. And I also wanted to wait until World of Warships on test server, because this is the first time I'm on the World of Warships test server, and I like it. The only thing I wish they did was add a training room. That's the only thing I want them to do in World of Warships, is that training room feature. But that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye, guys. See yas. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.